What is going on, everybody? How you doing? Hope you're doing great. Let me know you're there in the chat. Yo, what's good? Yo, Tyler, how you doing? Let me just switch one little thing here. Edit the audience. And let's switch that to public again. And hell yeah, we live. Yo, Victor, what's good? How you doing? So, let me turn that music down a little bit. Good man, glad to tune in. Yo, I'm happy that you tune in. Yesterday we did some clap processing. Or actually like not clap processing, but clap synthesizing. And today we will do a little bit more processing on them. And as someone requested, we will do some Foley recordings. We will do some Foley layering with claps and all that stuff, maybe even snares. And yeah. Hola, ¿qué tal, amigo? ¿Yo tienes bien? I hope that was right. Yeah. Let me just see. I think the ducky needs to be a bit higher here. Yeah, let's just switch over to the door. I think we have a few people already in. So, yeah, have to get rid of that one. And I will leave a little bit of the background music in the background. So if let me know if that actually is good or bad, because yeah, I just think that's a bit more entertaining if there's something in the back. Yeah, cool. So I did a little review of what we did yesterday, and I, as I referenced yesterday with a clap from one of Virtual White packs, I have had the feeling that they were way too bright, the claps I've made. So I just want to show you the little difference here. Let me see, where is actually, did it, yeah, that should, so there should be another folder here, which somehow isn't. So I've did some revisions on them, especially the EQ stuff on these. I didn't want you to bother with that. Mostly I took out a lot more of the high end, because I've boosted that again, and I did that in the creation process in the beginning. So yeah, that was just way overdone. I think I've had some ear fatigue and stuff. So I've got rid of some of the high end here. And this is what the clap sounds right now. Yeah, so this is how they sound now. I think the last two sound pretty similar, but yeah, these are the clap sounds now, and I think they're way closer now to the Virtual White ones, just EQ-wise. So this is the Virtual White one. And this is the clap I've made. And I think they sound way more realistic now. I have the old ones here too, so we can revise what I did here. So these were the ones how they were before. Oh damn, not in every track. Want them, yeah, just like that. So they were way brighter. So that compared to that, I mean, it doesn't sound bad right off the bat, But I think I've really overdone it with the high content. And yeah, I still kept those, so I will try them in my tracks, and see which sounds better. But I think something less drastic high would sound way better in the end. So yeah, cool. So how are you doing, everybody in the chat? Let me know what you've been up to today. How you are, if there's anything special in your life right now. And we will start here in, right now with, I'm thinking, should I start with Foley recording and then use that Foleys for layering them on the claps and all that stuff to create new ones or more processed ones? Or should we do first some more processing to these claps and then record some Foleys? Let me know what you think about that. I think I need to change why. So this isn't picking up my audio device right here. So I think I have to switch one thing. Let me just do that real quick. Okay, do Foleys first. That was the first answer. So let me see. You can still hear this, right? Yeah, so cool. I think now it should work with my mic too. I have to turn my mic level down a little bit just for recording, so not clipping. Let me know if you can still hear me okay-ish, or if that even sounds better. Yeah, so Foley recording. I haven't really prepared much, so I'm just gonna click the record button here and get some stuff out here. Maybe I even record some claps and stuff. Let me just... Okay, so this is maybe a bit too loud. So I'm turning down my mic intentionally a bit quieter so I don't have clipping and... so the sounds I record just don't go... over the zero crossing thing, not the zero crossing, but it just doesn't clip naturally because that I can show you just a little recording here. So so you can see some turn that down again, so some of the content just gets totally lost because it just get crushed here at the top, and that way it's you can't really make that. It's a bit better to use sounds that are a bit lower and then turning them back up digitally. That's just what I think works a bit better. And yeah, let me just so I'm not going into the red, still in the red. Still in the red. Okay, but I think I won't clip that hard. And yeah, I'm just gonna hit record and drag a few things here. Maybe make some noises with my mouth. And let's see. That's really quiet. Let's turn that up a little bit more. Check. Okay. Yeah, let's turn it up a little bit more. I think that makes more sense. Good damn, sorry about these claps. let's mute these.
Loud. So much money. I've got the money in the bank or in the what's up, bro? Christian, don't wonder, I'm recording some Foley samples here. Yeah, don't wonder, I'm recording some Foley samples here. it probably looks very, very, very silly, but... hi, Brazil! How you doing, everyone? Thanks for joining. I will continue with that shit. pads are totally... what type of mic do you have? I have the Audio Technica ATH2020. I think that's the name. Sorry, my fans are totally ruining the recordings. I hope it's not too loud. I think that's enough with the pants here. Let's do some more stuff. And if you have any ideas what I should record, just let me know. I'm just doing like really, really random stuff here. Super fresh. Thank you. So.
We're back, everybody. We just pull up that cam back. So we've got a bunch of crazy Foley recordings. I don't actually know if there's anything good in here, but we will figure it out together. If you have any ideas what else I could record, just let me know. I just recorded like really, really random stuff. But I think we will get some good stuff out of that. So the first step when we have a recording like that is to just listen to it, dig through it, and just find the parts we like, isolate them, and then we can process them on their own. And yeah, let's see. Let's take a listen. First of all, I'm gonna try to pull up the audio here, and I will turn down the background noise for that, so we can hear it a bit better. I'm just gonna make the cuts on the parts where I think maybe I could use some of that, and I delete the ones that I don't want to use. I think that part is pretty interesting. So that and that, I don't really like the beginning here, but these. Maybe even that little sound here, which is super, super quiet. But if we turn it up, maybe it's something interesting. Yeah, so that's like a super random one, but just some background noise. But those kind of sounds always work pretty good. So I'm just gonna consolidate that one and make that even louder. Yeah, so we have that in isolation here. And yeah, even here, these little big background things, maybe these could work. And I'm hearing a lot of fan noise and all that. So that probably doesn't work here. That's like the little slap of that thing here. And this could be like a cool layer for a transient or something like that. So I'm gonna leave them. And that's an interesting sound. It's super quiet. Just gonna. Could be like a cool kick layer, maybe. And these ones too, like these super organic sounds do great layers on drums to make them sound way more naturally. And maybe we will do a little folder with these little noise samples, just to have them like to layer with drums and stuff. Kind of like those. And yeah, this takes some while, but it's totally worth it. Because you have some cool SafeMate stuff that no one has because you recorded it yourself. So I think that was the paperback thing. Yeah, that sounds interesting. Let's keep that. Consolidate it and make that louder. Yeah. And that's a cool little layer here too. So basically I'm just I just keep everything. But doesn't that sound cool? Like if you layer that on a snare or something. I think that is the money stuff from my money back. I love those. I love money, okay. Just gonna save that real quick before these samples get lost. Ooh, that sounds great. And we can even isolate some of those later on. Ooh, that one sounds awesome. Yeah, and these make great layers. Am I late? Yo, Proxer, what's going on? A little bit. Not too late though. I just recorded a bunch of stuff into my mic. Does that even work? The uptime, is there like a special bot thing? I don't know if that works. Let me know if that works. Yeah, I just recorded some percussive stuff. Oh god, that was hard. I think we're live for like 30 minutes, not that long though. Yeah, recorded some own Foleys and just weird noises. And we will use these to layer some more stuff. Yeah, and these sound pretty cool. How you doing, Jonas? Yeah, so we have these super organic sounds. I love those. And you can hear that background noise. We will get rid of that with a gate later on. There was a cool sound. That one. That would be a great little layer for a snare or a clap or something. Because we have to fade that. But that's like a cool layer. Ooh. I don't know why those kind of sounds make it so interesting. I think that little pre-thing here was cool too. It was loud. Yeah, till the end here. And maybe even we could like categorize them. I don't know if that makes sense. Let's call this coins. So as we go, we can drag these down, everything that has to do with coins. This kind of sounds like a reload thing. Weird. I think that's how I pronounce it right. I think these are some weird sounds. I think maybe that is more like a coin stuff. That's coins too. What's that? That's coins too. I know, that sounds weird to me. That's coins too. I think that all comes from the coins. That's coins too. I don't know what the weird stuff is though. Yeah, that's weird stuff. That's too, like it's just some rumbling noise. Yeah, transient sounds. Just let's put these short ones in the here. I think they're pretty cool. So that's nothing. We have that. That is definitely some weird stuff. What is it even called? Like this little hair thing here. I have no idea what's that called in English. I think I never used that word. Can you help me? What's that? Damn. Let's call it hair thing. That's the hair thing now. We have some more hair thing here. Yeah, and let's continue. Let's save that real quick. Need some water. There is something in the water. I call this one a hair broom. I have no idea. Hair broom, that could work.
I don't know. Let's Google that.
Come, English. So in German it's come. Komp, maybe. Or quest. I think it's a... Yeah, I think it's a komp. Then, and let's call that hair comb hair thing a hair broom. I have to take a look. What's a hair broom? So that's a hair broom. Yeah, doesn't look like something you should put in your hairs. Why is my PC so loud today? Damn. Let's put that to normal mode again. So what else do we have? And I've turned down the background music because we wanted to hear that right. So that's a cool sound. That's coins, definitely. And that's a cool sound. Let's pull it up. Yeah, let's just drag that out a bit. And I think that's a really cool little transient thing here again, because it's just really short and snappy. I mean, basically it's the coin noise, but yeah, let's do it with coins. What's that? So I just really love to make these little background noise things really loud and see how they sound loud. Or even like transpose down. I know, that doesn't work. And we will post-process them as soon as we have those sounds. And goddamn, that's a lot of work. Should we do all of these in the stream, or should I just go over some post-processing and do that outside of the stream? Let me know what you think. It's not like the most funny part to have me going through that, isn't it? I don't know, honestly. Yeah, me neither. I mean, do you enjoy to watch that? Have I'm going through that or not? I mean, I think it's... Honestly, like, I've never seen somebody do something like that, so maybe that's interesting. I don't know, probably some people have done it, but I think that was a pretty cool idea from Aaron. I think he said that I should do that because he was interested in that. So that's like a little cool transient sound again. And I think these could make it in the... And two. Yeah, let's boost these up again. That's a cool little sound here too. Really snappy. That could be like a cool snap layer, maybe. Pull that into that too. How much more do we have to go through? So we have like maybe that's like an eighth, not even. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So we have like a tenth of the sounds. As you ask how much we have to go through. We don't have. I could start doing some post-processing to those we have already, and then I don't know. Haven't really thought about that before. That's why I asked if I should go more through that, or if I should start processing them. I mean, it's not like the most fun thing to watch, is it? I don't know what I can pull off with the coins. So I'm basically just recording a bunch of those and putting them in a little pack, and you can use these Foley sounds to make your track sound more human and more natural, I'd say. And yeah, that really, really works great with layering that on your for example clap sounds or snares, or just as in between sounds in the drop, because those little kind of things are in the end what makes the track interesting. So if you would, normally I do like a lot of that stuff to just layer on my tracks to make them, yeah, more unique, and to add some ear candy. And yeah, that's just the creation process of those kind of sounds, those fully natural sounds. It's not like you make a full track out of these. I mean, you probably could, but that's like a weird noise. And that's a little cool sound here. Let's pull that up to the weird. Yo, what's good, Aaron? You're pretty late. I've done 45 minutes here. And I'm doing the thing you asked about. So I've recorded some Foleys with you guys together. So for EQing these, what's your process, I guess? Yo, yeah, it really depends on the sound. I would probably start by just adding a little gate on these. Let's finish these coin sounds, and then we start with the processing, because yeah, there are tons of more sounds on that. Basically, for processing, probably I will take out all the low end under 100 hertz, just because that is a lot of that low rumbly noise coming from my fans and all that stuff. Then probably boosting some of the top end, because my mic is kind of missing that top end stuff. And yeah, we will go through that in just a bit. I will just finish that coin stuff. I think we don't have that many coins left. Really love those sounds. That's a bit of a weird sound, isn't it? Awesome, thank you. Yeah, like I said, we will go through that in just a bit. And even those sounds, like, it's super, super random, but you can try to layer that with your drums, and it's just super interesting. More coin stuff here. And yeah, it's a bit of a tedious process. But for me, actually, it's kind of fun to see what came actually out of my mic, because when I'm doing all that stuff, it isn't really like obvious. I mean, it is obvious because I'm recording these, but yeah, like all these different background noises you could really pick up with your ears. That's just what the mic is picking up. And it's super interesting if you listen to these details, I think. Is that right pronounced, details? That sounds wrong. Almost like Beatles. Yeah, that's interesting. And more coins here. I think we have to be somewhere done with the coins, don't we? Damn, why are there so many coins? I have too much money in my bag. I wish that was the case, but it isn't. Ooh, and I love that little ant here. So let's pull that up. So it's like, it's almost like a glitch sound. really cool. That sounds cool too. Sounds are really good, to be honest. By the way, what's your opinion about recording through mobile? Is it that bad? No, it's not that bad. Actually, I do some recording with my phone too. It just depends, like, how you EQ it in the end. I mean, sometimes phone speaker or phone microphones tend to clip really, really early. I think that's one of the things you should take care of, because like I said, I mean, you weren't there, so I'm just gonna show it to you again. If you make a recording and it's I just did some recordings here, and the first one was really, really loud, and you can immediately see that the top end just really gets crushed, or like the loudest parts just get really, really crushed, and you can almost see like a cut here, and that's just really bad, because you can't push these back in post. They will just stay like that. So if I try to make that more silent, you can just see it's super cut out. I mean, that doesn't sound too bad now, but if you compare that to a clap that's recorded with much lower volume, or if you record it a bit further away, that little thing, for example, here, you can push that a bit more. Just, I mean, that's like probably a really bad example, because that looks just so weird. But yeah, just take care of that little clipping noise. And by the way, we haven't recorded any claps and mouth noises. I wanted to do that too, but especially like, yeah, where do these coin noises stop?
In the what's up, Rondo? I'm recording.
Okay, so here do they stop? Let me just quickly go through that. I just now take out these that are really interesting, because we have so many of these. Yeah, that's like an interesting sound here. That's like an interesting sound. I think we have some of those though.
So much money. I've got the money in the bank. Or in the what's up? I've got the money in the bank.
I've got the money in the bank. I've got the money.
Yeah, that's a pretty dope vocal.
I've got the money in the bank. I've got the money in the bank. I've got the money in the bank.
When's my birthday? I have birthday in February, 23rd February.
What's up, bro? Christian, don't wonder, I'm recording some full.
Okay, so I think we have everything now, haven't we? Okay, that's like a super cool noise. Almost forgot that one. I've got that money in the bank, yeah. Yeah, I've got it. Not much, but I've got some. That's like a cool transient noise.
So much money.
And that you, so much money. We could maybe use that as a pre-drop.
So much money. So much. So much money.
So much money. So much money. So much. So much money. So much. So much money. So much money. So much money. So much money. So much money.
Andy. What's up, bro? And don't wonder, I'm.
It's really, really funny to go through these recordings. Let me just record some claps because I forget that, and I wanted to layer February 20. Oh man, we're really close. So are you like a water man or a fish? Then I think you're a fish already, aren't you? So let's record some claps here, because I forgot that. So these are some claps. We will use those. Make a channel in Discord where we can share Foley samples. Hell yeah, let's do that. I think I have like a little sound design channel there. Let me see, music. Yeah, I have that sound design channel. Maybe we could use that for that. I'm just gonna post your Foley samples here. Or we could do like another Foley channel. Hola Lionel, how you doing? Hope you're doing great. Yeah, that sounds awesome. Let's use that clap. And the reverb on those sound really cool. And these are super cool to layer with our synthesized claps in the end. Always cool to have some organic layers on there. Snappy clappy claps, yeah, they're really snappy because of my small hands. Ooh, that one sounds great. That's like the smallest clap in the world, but maybe we can use that. Yeah, that snap sounds great. Let's make a new one, snaps. And that's usually how I go about like recording stuff. So I make the different channels and then I pull these in there. By the way, do you guys enjoy these kind of streams? Because that's not like really production. Ain't your vocal stuck in a little bit while Ableton is playing audio? I think it's the other way around. So Ableton is stuck in when I'm pulling up my voice, so, but that's only like, that's only through a voice meter, so I'm not recording that. What does it sound to you like my voice is ducking? Great to hear that you enjoy these. I know, like Jonas, for example, Proxer, you're probably not enjoying these too much. I'm really sorry about that, but I wanted to do some of these sound design streams. I will do some more production streams really soon, probably tomorrow. I know I said that yesterday, but couldn't make it today. I really, really appreciate that you're in here regarding that, that you're not in that much into production. That really means a lot to me. And yeah, just take out all these little clap sounds. That sound really bad, so let's get rid of that. Oops. How many more claps do we have? It was like the big chunky clap. It's like a ass clap. Another one of those. Ooh, that's like a Patreon. Yeah, cool. So what should we start with processing? Should we it's a question. Should we start processing those individually, or should we use them directly as a layer for the ones we've made before? What do you guys think? I mean, we could probably do some processing to those. So I'm just gonna make a new channel where I drag those samples in. I think I have to quit here again in a little bit, because it's getting really late again. So I would get rid of some of the low end here. And then maybe, yeah, like I said, put a gate before everything. So we get rid of a little bit of that. Actually, let's use a kilohertz gate. Seem to work pretty good on noises. Yeah, and then let's use a Pro L to bring everything back up. See how that sounds. Put that to safe mode, or maybe to yeah, let's use punchy. Maybe we could even use some, what do we have in here? Swing hits, totally punchy loudness. Yeah, I think the key here is to full setting to have a bit of a higher attack so the transient comes through. Yeah, so that would be like a pretty cool clap. What do you think about that? I'm gonna export that. Maybe we could even put a little bit of... I can barely hear you. The clap is louder than my alarm. Oh, damn. Oh, yeah. Sorry, I've put the... Is that better now? Should be better. So maybe we could put a little bit of reverb on the clap. Thanks for letting me know, by the way, that my voice is too low. Didn't recognize that. And then we could place a little bit of reverb on this, maybe too. That's way too long. Oops. And there, the convolution reverb even has those made for drums thing. Let's see, drum booth, snare. Is there something for claps? Maybe we could just use like a little snare chamber. And just with a little bit of decay, not that much. Yeah, it already gives this kind of cool room. Which one did we have? I think it was that one, right? Yeah, let's export that as our clap organic one. And like I said, I have to leave here, unfortunately, in just a bit. And let's drag that down right here. No worries, we will continue with that. Yeah, let's do that as organic too. What do you think about that sounds, by the way? Do they sound good or not? Let me know. That's a cool clap. Yeah, that sounds awesome. Let's export that. Just drag that a little bit to the front here. Organic 3. I love them as per my whole experience. Man, that's great to hear. Cool that you have some fun. That's why I'm doing that. That one needs like a lot of top end. let's use a not that deep curve on the I'm just switching through. Switching through some different rooms here. And yeah, let's finish those claps and then I have to, oh, damn. Where are they? There are they. I mean, those are a lot though. Probably can't do every single clap today, but we will continue with those tomorrow. And this isn't like the best sound. Yeah, when we pitch that down, it sounds a bit cooler. Maybe we could put some OTT on here too. Yeah, let's use that one. Just gonna do the same thing again here. And no problem, you tomorrow, heat. Yeah, tomorrow will be some heat as we layer these with our original claps. And maybe before I stream tomorrow, maybe I can go through a bit more of the recordings we've made. I've even played some guitar for you guys here in the at the end. Here we go. Isn't that beautiful? Just did some random stuff. I'm playing not that good guitar as I wanted to, but
thank you.
Yeah, let's use that one, and that will be our last one today. I really have to stop here. I could go on for hours, but I have to leave. Let's listen to what we've accomplished today. So claps. Actually, by the way, voice is active. Yeah, voice should be active. We're jamming to you in our Discord right now. What do you mean? Let me open the Discord. You jam it for us, for me. Where do you jam? Yeah, and that's a great idea, by the way. It's a great idea to send some Foley stuff. To send some Foley stuff in our in the Discord. By the way, guys, please make sure to join the Discord server here. Yeah, I've just posted the little link here in the stream. We'll post that here too. Yeah, please make sure to join me there on the Discord server. Make sure to follow me on Twitch, on YouTube, turn on the notifications and all that stuff. That really, really helps me. Make sure to share the stream, make sure to like the stream, make sure to comment, interact with me. That's really, really growing the stream a lot. Yeah, I will go here in just a bit. I just want to show what we accomplished here. Unfortunately, today it's not really... I have no idea why it doesn't refresh like it should. So we accomplished not really much, actually. Yeah, I've did some... We EQing on the claps we've did yesterday, so these this is how they sound now. Yeah, and today we achieved these few claps here, and I recorded a bunch of Foleys. Yeah, and tomorrow we will layer the claps with the so the synthesized claps with those claps to make some interesting sounding stuff. For example, that already sounds so much better, doesn't it? But yeah, we will go into that tomorrow. Yo, Proka, thanks for saying that. Really, really appreciate that you say stuff like that. Make sure to follow me on Twitch and all that stuff. I've posted the link. I will post it again. Join my Discord server and such so we can hang out together. And yeah, unfortunately, I have to leave now, but I will stream tomorrow again at around 1 p.m. EST. Then we will continue with the clap processing here and layer some claps and do some more Foley stuff to make some interesting sounds. And yeah, thanks everyone for joining, for interacting with the stream. It was a lot of fun. For me, the stream was really, really funny. I've been already following you. Yeah, thanks you. Love you too, man. Much love. Yeah, like I said... tomorrow we will do some more stuff. I really enjoy those kind of streams where I do some random stuff, recording and all that. So yeah, let me know if you like it. I mean, I've got some, I've got money in the bank. Yeah, so that's what we got.
Got the money in the bank.
That sounds so good.
Got the money in the bank. So much money. I've got the money in the bank.
That's like a
the money in the bag.
Super cool pre-door book. we'll continue on that tomorrow. It was a lot of fun, and let me know if you like that stream or not. That's cringe. It is, but yeah, I don't know. It's kind of cool too. Yo, this Ricky, I have no idea. Did I pronounce that right? This Ricky. I have to leave now, unfortunately. Make sure to follow me on Twitch, on YouTube, all that stuff. Again, thanks for interacting that much. It was a lot of fun. And especially thanks for all the people that are queuing to the stream every single day, like Aaron or Jonas. I've been seeing you guys for a lot right now. Or Tyler, you were one of the first two. And I'm really, really glad that you joined. Victor is here a lot too. And sorry if I forgot anyone. Christian and Cristiano, I've saw you guys a lot too. And yeah, thank you guys for joining. Thanks for supporting. No, I'm a beatboxer. Dude, that's interesting. Send me some samples. I would love to incorporate some beatbox stuff in my tunes too. Or maybe even and sample packs and stuff. Yeah, thank you guys, and stay healthy, stay home, and have a great day. Bye. Yeah, Praka, make sure to join the Discord server on the link tree I've sent, and send some beatbox samples in the sound design section there. So maybe we can use them in some of the upcoming tracks here. Would be really cool. Yeah, cool. Thanks, guys, and have a great day. Bye. Where's my fist bump?